folks, once again, Heck Dolo, we're bringing you another needle drop. We got a special needle drop for you today, because, you know, we dropping the album on Tuesday, so we're giving you a little something special for Monday, the day before the album drops. And what we're going to cover today, which I know I promised y'all a while ago and we didn't get a chance to do it, is we're going to do a needle drop consisting of all drum breaks. That's right, folks. All drum breaks for needle drop tonight. So for y'all that that know these, sit back and enjoy. For you that are not familiar with these breaks and haven't heard them before, pay close attention. Be something that'll help you in the future. Alright, let's get this started. So I was out digging in Toronto a few years back, and I got up with my man Dan. If any of you want on Instagram, y'all know him as Crate Digging. So he was nice enough to host me out in Toronto while I was there, to hit some record spots. So this is one of the joints that I caught when I was out there with him. I'm going to be real honest with you. Guy's name is Roberto Schaffisi. So it's an Italian record. Not something you're going to see in the U.S. that easily. May something you have to go online and look for eBay or some craziness like that, but it was pretty dope. Had a pretty ill drum break on it, some grooves and stuff like that, so I snatched it up, you know. Plus, you know, when you're outside of the country digging, Toronto or wherever it may be, out of your state, you know, and you find something dope, you usually just snatch it up. So let's rock with this and keep it moving. Sure. Nice little funky groove to go with it. Wow, folks, there you go. Funky drum break. Nice groove. The whole record is dope too, by the way. Just in case anybody's wondering, like, if there's only that drum break. It's a pretty funky record. Dude plays guitar, so it's definitely worth picking up.
Now, what category would that be in if you were in the record store?
Might actually be, if I had to take, well, it depends on the record store. If you go into a record store that has all types of genres, it'll probably be in the
Italian. Foreign?
Yeah, foreign Italian. So, but I would probably classify it under sort of like a progressive, like rock type, okay, jazz, fusion type thing, just from hearing the album itself.
Yeah, too bad there's no progressive rock, jazz, fusion section in the record store.
Yeah. They usually just put it on the prog. It's just prog rock is what they call it.
You know, I've never seen a prog rock section in a record store. It's all under rock.
I've never seen a... Depending. I've been to a few record stores where they separated under prog.
Really?
Yeah, they'll just put it like prog, and that'll be, boom, you already know that's the section. Oh. And then they got the rock section, because they'll separate it, and they'll put like the hard rock separate from the regular prog rock.
I've never seen that shit. They got White Snake and the Bee Gees and all that shit all together.
It's very few. You don't see it often, but I do see it. Now, this is a drum break that I found maybe a year ago. This was from that trip where you were supposed to come to Winston-Salem with me, and y'all end up going to that digging excursion out in Richmond.
Yeah, warehouse joint.
Yeah, the warehouse joint. So, but this is something I've been looking for a minute. I knew about it, but every time I seen it, they wanted too much money for it. So I didn't pay what's actually on this cover here, which is the $12. I paid way less than that. But,
okay.
You know, every time I see it, they wanted like 12 and up, and I was like, I'm not paying record. So, but this is Atomic Rooster. The name of the song is, if I'm correct, Gershatzer or something like that, if I'm pronouncing it correct. But it's got a wicked drum break on it. I mean, it's one of those drum breaks that it just had me flipping out, because it's got so much dynamic to it, to where when you chop it up, you can just really, really get busy with it. And I've used it and like really killed the drum break because
it's on a real familiar record label. I can tell from the jacket.
So this is basically like.
Yeah.
Then you got all those fills that are in there.
Hold up. Then it's gonna go into some wax stuff.
Yeah.
The whole song is just drums? Like that? The drummer?
Just that whole ending of that one song is just like...
It's at the end of the song.
Yeah, it's at the end of the song. And the drummer just gets really busy with it, you know. They give him his little solo. It's his time to shine. He's like, yo, give him my little shine. I'm going to get it on. So he just went ham.
He's like, fuck it. I'm already in a group name.
Exactly.
Tommy Brewster. I might as well fucking get my shit off.
So, see it, pick it up. dope drum break. Alright, so this is it's a Christian rock album.
Name Armageddon.
Armageddon Experience. It's the experience. You gotta experience the Armageddon
Experience, okay.
So, and this record I picked up on a dig-in excursion with Jay Cyanide. We were heading down to NC and it's funny because we were making a trip, and while we were driving down, like we were looking for record stores on the way down. So on the way down to NC, we were stopping at little towns and going digging. We turned a 6-hour trip into like a 11-hour trip because we just kept stopping to go dig at different spots on the way down. And then on the way back, we did the same thing. And it was crazy because I remember there was one spot that we couldn't get to, and I called the guy. I'm like, what time are you open tomorrow? And it was a holiday. I can't remember what holiday it was. It might have been Easter, to be honest with you. Easter Sunday. And he was like, well, you know, I wasn't planning on opening tomorrow. He's like, but I got to stop by the shop to do some cleaning up and whatever. He's like, so if y'all want to come by, he's like, just let me know. I'll be there. So we came by the shop and picked up a few joints. And this happened to be one of those records that I picked up there. It was pretty dope. Let's see if I can remember the song. Sunday. It's probably the other side. Yeah, it's the other side. Quick break. Everything is panned on that one side too, so don't really pan it out yet. What we need is revolution. Listen to it. It's all panned out. So the break is all on that side. And the guitar's on that side. So when you sample it and pan it out, you got nothing but drum over there. So. And that's for y'all folks, if you don't know, I know the more experienced diggers are very familiar with it for maybe you folks that are just starting out. The way they mix stuff back then, they would pan different things to different sides of the stereo spectrum, so sometimes you'll get a record where, for instance, this is a perfect example, it'll be the drums which is be on one side of the speaker and then all the music will be on the other side. And sometimes you'll find it like that with singing too, where, you know, there'll be vocal parts that'll be in the left speaker and it'll just be nothing but music on the right side. So it's pretty ill just the way they mix back then. A lot of
45s are like that.
Yeah, a lot of 45s just to cover the full stereo spectrum, which is kind of dope because, you know, as a producer that does sample stuff, it makes it real convenient when you're listening to a record and the drums are isolated to a whole different side, or, and you got...
Or the singing is isolated from the instruments.
Yeah, for the instruments, you can just grab that section without any sort of like conflict or interruption from the other part. So you can pretty much take the drums out of the whole song and you got just the music by itself, or you can grab the drums and get rid of the music. So it's weird stuff like that, yeah. But it's dope.
There's also a way you can do it with, you have to rewire your tone arm where you can do it. I've seen it done.
But for the turntable?
Yeah, on the turntable.
Well, I used to do it on the turntable. I stopped doing it now just because of the way my setup is. But if you wire the mixer, basically take one wire and put it to one side and to the other side, and you leave your fader in the middle, and it'll play it out full stereo. But if you flip it to the right, then it'll give you that half. Or if you flip it to the other side, exactly, it'll give you that half. Yeah, I used to have my joint set up like that for a long time. But then when I did the whole new setup, I changed it out and was like, eh, we're going to do this. Because I can easily go into the MPC and pick whatever side I want. You know what I'm saying? With the tools that they put in there, I can isolate the left and the right side without having to physically do it myself before it goes into the thing.
Really?
Yeah. You can go in there. There's a feature in there that lets you, it'll let you transform or bounce it out to grab just the left side or grab just the right side.
Maybe I should take my shit out the box.
Love technology. Yeah, you should take your shit out the box, catch it. Dude, you had your joint. Well, you got your joint from me.
Yeah, when did you buy it?
I bought it like when it first came out. I had them join some pre-orders.
Yeah. Cause we had it pre-ordered.
Yeah, pre-ordered. Like, folks, like they first came out, I bought mine, and no one can get their hands on them, and I ended up finding a way to get two of them pre-ordered. And
I bought that one off of you.
And Gadget took the one off of me, so.
And it's still in the box.
It's still in the box, you're sad.
God
it's
damn
in
it. The box.
This is a drum break I found. And I don't think anybody really knew about it. Alright, there it is. So, just randomly digging at one of my spots that I usually go to. Put it out there because it doesn't make a difference. The spot is blown. It's Game Exchange or Record Exchange, however they want to name themselves. The Silver Spring one. Oh. You know, I don't really deal with it too much anymore because it's kind of spot is kind of beat, like it's hit or miss. It's not like it used to be back in the day.
A lot of Donna Summer records.
Yeah,
and
hit or miss. Plus, there's so many people. It's like oversaturated spot now. Everybody's in there digging, so
right. It
makes it hard.
But they got
10
Cent records.
I know.
You can't beat 10 Cent records.
10 Cent records are not, dude. If I can't find anything,
you know what? All right. You should just go in there, get a 10 Cent record.
I mean, I got a 10 Cent record that's worth a lot of money. That I caught because they didn't know what it was. So I caught it out of there and it was 10 Cent. I was like, all right. I was like, yeah, I don't know what it is. Good, you know?
Right.
It's a $700 record, but I paid 10 cents for it because they didn't know what it was. Which worked out in my favor. But this, you know, I just stumbled across. I was like, all right, let me listen to it. It looks interesting enough. Kaleidoscope.
Who's the artist?
Kaleidoscope is the band, I think.
Oh.
If I'm correct. Yeah,
got one motherfucker on the cover.
Yeah. That's the band, so. And I'd never seen it before, and I've never heard the break before, so it was kind of like, all right, boom, it's got a break on it. And you know, it's always about finding new stuff. When you're a digger, finding stuff that you never heard before, stuff no one knows about. You know, and it was fun because I found this, and this even stumped my man. If anybody knows DJ Cool Breeze, who freaking be selling records on Instagram.
Out of B-More?
Yeah, he knows a lot. Like, he knows a lot of stuff. And this had him stumped. And had my man Jack stumped, too. My man Big Jack, who knows a lot of stuff, too. Had the both of them stumped. They were like, yo, what is that? Like, wait. So I was like, all right, I know I found something new then. If they don't know about it, so. Don't say your boy Hekdolo ain't ever put you down with new shit, because I don't think anybody sampled that one yet. It's pretty knock and break, too. I'm not going to lie. I haven't got a chance to use it yet, but we're going to work that in soon. Kaleidoscope, folks. Look for it. They have two records, too, with breaks on it. It's a group called Minaj out of Canada. So, the homie Crate Digging Dan put me down with this as well. Got this through a trade with him. And if y'all see it, pick it up. It's a real, real dope drum break. Solid. It's just solid.
Sounds like a live album.
It is a live album. Yeah, it's a live album.
Gotcha.
That snare is just beast. Snare's beast on that record. And the drums are real solid. They're like that Climax Blue, like thick, solid type.
Yeah.
Like that. If anybody's familiar with Climax Blue Band, blues band, and you know the way those drums hit, they got that real solid, like heftiness to it. That's the way those drums hit. Real nice. All right. Now this record, some people are like, eh, it's cool. Because it's a library record. Sheffield Drum Library. Some folks are like, it's all right. This is just a library record. But I'm going to tell you what I like about this Sheffield record a lot. Besides the fact that every side is just drums from beginning to end, there's a lot of fills and different variations of hi-hats and snare rolls and all of that. That even if you don't want to sample just a straight break from this record, you can grab so many variations of fills to put in between your drums. So if you banging out kicks and snares and it feels like it's just too choppy and you want it to feel a little bit more seamless and let it flow a little more so it feels like it's actually a drummer playing, this is a good record to have because it gives you all that little extra that you need on the in-between. For those folks, it's like, well, it's playing real slow, okay? Throw it on 45 and... changes up everything. But as you can hear, there's a lot of dynamic to it, like the way he's playing, like, and as you go deeper into the record, playing a lot of different patterns. So if any of you trying to get like better on your actual drum programming techniques on your MPCs or whatever it may be, it's definitely a good record to listen to. Because if you listen to the pattern you got, definitely a great record to have in your library if you do not have one. Jump online and look for it. Not just for
because you won't find that in the record store.
You're not gonna find it in the record store. You know, and not necessarily just for the sample aspect, but for the educational aspect as well. It's definitely a highly recommended record.
Motherfuckers don't want no education. They just want the fucking drums.
You know, if you're gonna really do this and you're gonna be a musician and you wanna, you know, you gotta learn something. I mean, just sampling is cool, but when it comes to drum programming, you know, breaks work out. I like breaks. I love breaks. Don't get me wrong, but it's good to know how to actually program a drum too. Man. Actually bounce that drum and add variations to it and all of that. So
you sound like the motherfucker off Menace to Society. Oh, you trying to kick some knowledge, Sharif? You trying to kick some knowledge, Sharif?
For that one, Gadget. All right, so some folks would be familiar with this.
Yes.
Enough of you should be familiar with it. Clyde McFadder, the song is entitled Mixed Up Cup. Definitely a break used by a lot of people. First person that comes off to the top of my head is on the Common Resurrection album. What song was that again?
You know, I don't know.
I can't think of the name of the song. It's on there though. When you hear the drums, you'll know. Yeah. I'm having a mental block right now.
I'll call Large Pro after we get done with this and ask him.
We can do that, right? give homie a shout out.
Yeah. The snare's crazy.
Yeah, the snare's crazy. He's not the only person that used it. I'm trying to think. Like, so drawing a blank right now on the amount of folks that used it. But it's definitely a very notable drum. I think Tribe used it as well for one of their songs. It might have been Lyrics to Go that they rocked it for, if I can remember correctly. I think it was Lyrics to Go that they rocked it with. I got some shameless promotion going on here to remind you that the album drops tomorrow.
Take a look at the propaganda.
Yes, look at the propaganda.
Propaganda right here.
We are promo all the way. If some of y'all haven't heard the singles yet, you just tuning in for the first time. The City Life has been out for a couple of months yet. Videos out on YouTube. You can go to my website, hegdolo.com, which is up.
You got a website?
Yeah, got a website.
Oh shit.
Yeah.
Since when?
I've always had it. I just didn't really have it up and running the way it should have been for me.
So you're one of the people, you go to hegdolo.com and the GoDaddy page will come up? This web page is parked.
Maybe. Maybe.
Every producer should have a webpage.
Anyway, HegDolo.com is up and running. And on HegDolo.com, you can get to anything HegDolo that you need. You want to see all the Needle Drop episodes? They're on one page. You want to check out the SoundCloud beats? They're on one page. You want to go to Bandcamp? It's there. Whatever you need. You want to see what's going on current for Post? It's there. You know, all the stuff I produced in the past is there. Stuff I did currently is there. New single is there. One Time for Hip Hop, which dropped yesterday. Actually, no, Tuesday. No, yesterday, yeah. Dropped yesterday. So that's on, you heard that new right now, so jump on there, check it out. Video for One Time for Hip Hop will be coming next Tuesday, which is the date that the album drops. So be on the lookout for that. Video is going to be dope. Gadget is going to be dope. I'm telling you.
I believe you.
And if you haven't heard the single, go check it out. The single is dope. Everybody at this point is just, they going crazy over the One Time for Hip Hop single right now. Seriously. So, hit HegDolo.com and you can find a link to the single as well as the past singles and any other pertinent information that relates to this album. So, right. And
he'll have all these drum breaks and WAV file for you to download.
Start promising the people stuff there. False advertisement, Gadget.
I'm trying to get you traffic.
I also don't need the people cursing me out. Like, you said there was going to be free drum breaks. I ain't fucking with you no more.
I already know what this is.
Whoops, whoops. Yeah, so. Whatnots, folks. Whatnots on the rocks. The song is called Why Can't People Be Colors Too? Y'all should recognize the drum break already.
Oh my god.
Yeah, oh my god. If you're on the joints, it's a boy.
Yeah.
One it's of your great. Favorite songs. Extra Pro Joints. So. And they pretty much chop that joint like in between. It doesn't ever really just open up as a full break. Just kind of one of those breaks where they grab the kicks and snares and everything in between the horns. Whatnots on the Rocks. Very hard record to find. Anything Whatnots.
Like I really like the way Tribe used it. Like they put a bass line in between.
Yeah, they yeah.
Yeah, they
oh
freaked it.
Oh my god, yeah, they freaked it. They freaked it hard.
So, but It's a Boy's crazy too.
Yeah, that one is definitely crazy. So anybody that
one of my favorites.
Detroit Emeralds.
Definitely, D-Town in the house.
Yes.
Everybody and their mother has used this.
Everybody and their mother has used this. I mean, granted, the original will always be my favorite. And that will never change. So, now we know some of the likes of this has been Raekwon, Common, produced by Dilla.
Mm-hmm. What Raekwon song?
Incarcerated Scarfaces.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Incarcerated Scarfaces.
I gotta listen to it again.
Yeah. Yeah, it's Incarcerated
Scarfaces. You forgetting the main one.
No, I'm not forgetting the main one. That's the one I'm getting to.
Okay.
That's the one I'm getting to, which like I said is okay. Is my favorite of all time. You all know, right. Even though there's a lot of other folks that used it, the first one that always comes to mind for me is Main Source, Looking at the Front Door.
Oh, I was going to say Lisa Lisa and Cold Jam, but go ahead. No, I'm just joking. Go ahead.
Now, that's always going to be a classic for Looking at the Front Door. I don't care who else has used this. Nothing's going to top Looking at the Front Door for me.
Were they on Westbound at the same time as the Ohio Players?
I'm going to say yeah, because they look, yeah, 73 Ohio Players is roughly around that time. So, yeah, they're on Westbound roughly around the same time as Ohio Players. So, Detroit Emeralds.
But that's the only record I've seen of them. Like, yeah. I've never seen another Detroit Emeralds record.
I have. I've seen another one, but it wasn't that great, so I left it.
Oh, so
that's
the they had tax write-offs back then.
Yeah. that was the main
record labels right had tax there. Write-offs back then.
Now, this is one of these records you don't see often. This is one of these records I don't play often, as you can see. It is...
Is it still sealed?
No, it's not sealed, but the open flat part is not even accessible unless I actually take the plastic out. Off of it.
Gotcha.
Don't play it much. Power Zeus Grail piece.
Mm-hmm. The Holy Grail.
It's a Grail piece right here. Don't turn up too often, and when you do, you're gonna pay a little bit.
Now, how much is this record going for at record shows?
At record shows, if the dealer's trying to get you, they'll charge you probably a ball for it. So we're looking at about.
No.
Yeah, I mean, if you catch it online, or catch it maybe at a store, you can probably get it for like maybe 40, 45. No more than 50 at a store. But you got to catch it at the store. That's the thing.
That's $45 too much for me.
So, but...
I ain't bullshitting.
But any other time, folks will try to get you. And, a lot of folks use this. The first one that comes off of my mind is off the OC album. But I'm trying to think. I think Buck Wild has used them before. I can't remember what song he used them for, though. But you should notice them. I think... might have been the like woe drums too.
No
okay,
well, the woe drums is the band you talked about earlier. Climax Blues Band.
Oh, that. Okay, my bad, misinterpreting stuff now. I'm mixing up my drums.
Yeah,
that's Power of Zeus. If y'all see these folks, I highly recommend that you pick it up, as long as it's an original, not a reissue. Funny story with this record too. My man, Gil. You remember Gil was here with us one time. Hosted Needle Drop with us or whatever. Here for that Dilla weekend. I got this from him on a trade. So, but Gil, I don't know how.
A trade.
I don't know how this Bamba, but yo stumbled across like 5 of these joints. And for dirt cheap. But this was back like in the 90s. Okay, right. He just happened to stumble across a dealer on the Gold Mine pages. Anybody who's been digging for a while is familiar with Gold Mine.
Is that still around?
Yeah, it's still around. Shit. people still, yeah, they still go through the gold mine. He caught about 5 of them. Real cheap, too. Bought all of them from the dude. I was lucky enough to get one of them from a trade with him. And then he traded off the rest to some other folks for, like, big pieces, too. So, definitely one of my favorite drum breaks. Hits hard. A lot of people have used this as well. You're going to know as soon as you hear it. Of course, from the likes of Tribe, Erica, I think Beat Nuts, and a few other folks as well. So, it's a nice break. Joe Farrell. This up, woo! Kicks and snares. Oh, and Black Sheep.
I'm thinking Eric B. and Rakim Ghetto.
Them two?
Sounds like it.
Okay.
I could be wrong. Okay.
Ghetto. Black Sheep, though. That's the other one. So you're going to recognize these drums, guys, because these are something that I used. As soon as you hear it, you're going to be like, oh, that's what it is. I'm not going to tell y'all, folks, though. You're going to have to go and check out my catalog if you want to know. Basically, Flash Fearless is a compilation album, because I don't think it's an actual, group album, so, but it's got a whole bunch of joints on it. Drum breaks that I used, real nice, you can get to play with them in pause, and really rock them. You know what it is, guys.
No clue.
It's a joint I produced. One of my first joints. With Lalo.
No clue.
Still no clue.
I'm going to go to your website.
You have to go to my website.
And go to your SoundCloud page.
Peep the catalog.
Hecdolo.com.
Hecdolo.com for sure. Alright, so here's...
More propaganda. Right here. Alright,
so here's a little something. I got a few drum breaks, but in essence, these are all the same for folks who don't know. I got from George Semper. So Bill Cosby. To Chuck Jackson. Buzzfield Blues Band. Mad Lads. I know some of y'all are thinking, like, why the hell is he showing us all these records? What do they all have in common? Fireballs. Iron Butterfly. For those of you who don't know, I know some of you are going, oh, yeah, I know what it is. For those who don't know, what they all have in common, these records, is the all-contained versions of Get Out My Life, Woman. And pretty much, not all, so don't hold me to all, but most Get Out My Life, Woman song covers have drum breaks. A good majority of them do. So if you're out in the field and you're digging, and you come across a record that has a cover of Get Out My Life, Woman, I would suggest more than likely to give that record a listen.
Same pattern for all of them?
Same pattern for all of them. But the texture of the drums are different for all of them. That's what makes it so unique. So, this is the George Semter version of it. You'll probably recognize it from Correct. It was Pete that rocked with it and maybe a few other folks that used it.
I want to say KMD too.
Possibly KMD.
Or another version of it.
Or another version.
Now I know there's 500 versions.
There's a lot of versions that get out my life for me. So that's the George Semter version. I'm just going to run through all of them real quick. We got the Bill Cosby version.
You got the Ike Turner version?
I don't know if it's Ike Turner version. I know you're being silly, though. Clowning over here. Ike Turner version. Mess around and actually be an Ike Turner version.
He could have needed it.
So this is the Bill Cosby version of Get Out My Life, Woman.
Get out my life, woman.
And as I run through them, you can definitely tell that the textures of each one are different. Even though the pattern of the break is the same, all the drum textures are pretty much another, you know, feel to it because of the drum sets, obviously, that the drummers were using for each song that was recorded. This is a Chuck Jackson version of it. Chuck Jackson got 3 breaks too so far. He's got like 3 joints.
Get out my life, woman.
Now I'm gonna tell you right now, because of the way this was mixed and all of that stuff, the drum is really low. But I'm a little blown or mind blown because of any of you know that's off of De La's second album. I'm trying to think. De La Soul is Dead.
Is that Blue Mind State?
No, it's the one was the Afro Connect or whatever. I think. It's either the second or the third. It might be the third album. But yeah, I think it is Balloon Mind State. There's a song on there that they used that break for. And they got it real clean. Like, it's, you couldn't tell it was, because they got it real clean. I don't know how they managed to do that. Some hella EQing. But, yeah, it's the one that goes, this goes out to all those hardcore acts. You know which one I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Is that Blue Mind State?
I think so. I don't know the name of the song, though. I can't remember.
You know which one I'm talking about.
Yeah. Right. I gotta pull that album back out.
All right, so now this is a really good one. A little hard one to find, too. Mad Lads. Also a version of Get Out My Life, Woman. I don't play it too often, because it is, you know, a slightly difficult record to find. But it's a nice version of it too. And it's just a one bar, but it's like a bar of like a nice solid smacking drum. And this one I like a lot. That snare just feels like a smack in the face, how that snare feels when it hits. And this is on Volt, which Volt was like a subsidiary of Stack Records. So, trying to run through them as quickly as possible. And we got this other group called Fireballs Rock Group. Also version of Get Out My Life, Woman. Real trash can sounding snare. For anybody that's looking for some sort of texture like that, definitely a nice one to have in your catalog as well. And I'm gonna go with the last one that actually has a drum break, because this Buzzerfield drum blues band, it's like a half a break, it's not even like a full break on that record. And then this one is the Iron Butterfly. Sorry folks, Forget Out My Life Woman. Folks, Get Out My Life Woman series, and these are just a few that I have. There's many more out there that I don't have, so if you see them out there, pick them up in the field. Always nice to grab them every time you see them. So I hope y'all folks really enjoyed the needle drop drum break joints. Hopefully y'all get out there and start digging and start looking for some of these drum breaks. Once again, folks, remember, album drops tomorrow, 4/21. Single just dropped, last Tuesday or whatever. One Time for Hip Hop, album Deeper Than Plenty, Higher Than Most. It's going to be available, as you can see, iTunes, Google Play, Spotify. You can listen to it, MP3s for Amazon. Check out Lalo. HighDefinitionSociety.net. You can check me out on hypedolo.com. Look for the album, check it out. Video will be dropping on Tuesday, tomorrow as well, for the One Time for Hip Hop. And album be straight. We have a release party in New York on the 25th. Lalo was A Life loved the album. So they were like, yeah, sure, you can have the release party at our spot. And we're having our album release party at A-Life, which is phenomenal, because it's just not something every artist gets the opportunity to do, you know. So it's a privilege. So we're thankful to A-Life for having us to host the party there on the 25th. So, but folks, support. Please support. Album is going to be out. It's worth it. A few folks that have heard the album already, the going crazy about it. Folks are like, yo, this is it. This is the one. So, once again, tomorrow, Deeper Than Plenty, Higher Than Most, available on iTunes and every place else. Peace, folks. Hope you enjoyed the needle drop. And he's playing a lot of different patterns. So if any of you, trying to get like better on your actual drum programming techniques on your MPCs or whatever.